confidence in myself. When I couldn't play, I'm gonna tell you guys a funny story. Junior high school, when he was heading out jersey for the start of the season, the best players got the jerseys first. Since I was the worst player on the team, I got the last jersey. And the numbers on the jersey was 00. And my teammate used to tease me, that's an appropriate number since you can't play. They used to call me double nothing when I first started playing basketball.
And it stayed with you.
Stayed with me, yes.
Wow, I've never heard that story about the 00.
Yeah, that's how I got started. Yeah.
And I think you were the first player in the league that wore 00.
I can't say with certainty, but I think I am.
I think you did. Well, Robert played 21 years in the National Basketball Association. And I was telling Robert on the way over here, there are a number of people from the Bulls organization that are excited to see him and get reunited and reacquainted. Robert played for the Bulls in that 96-97 season. 69 wins for the Bulls, won another NBA championship, won a 4 rings for Robert Parish. And, you know, the first thing they always said was, Robert was a great teammate. So what is your definition, Robert, of a teammate? Because all these young people have and are teammates for their youth teams, whether it's basketball, baseball, other school sports. What makes a good teammate?
I think you should be non-judgmental, you should be supportive, and you should have unconditional belief in your teammates. You gotta believe in them and trust them, because your teammates is like an extended family member, because you spend so much time with your teammates. So I think it's very important that you have that love and understanding and respect for one another.
Okay, now Robert, a lot of these kids, some probably get a lot of playing time. Others are developing their game, maybe sitting on the bench. Maybe they don't get as much time as they like. So what are some of the recommendations as far as being a good teammate when you're not starting, when you don't get a lot of playing time? How can you still be a good teammate if you know that you're a reserve player?
I think it's very important to improve and get better. Understand what your weaknesses are and work on your weaknesses. Just don't work on your strength. And equally important, you got to have unshakable confidence in yourself. You got to believe in yourself when nobody else believes in you, because you're not going to be rewarded with instant gratification for the hard work and dedication that you put into it. But you got to believe that you're going to accomplish your objective and get better.
Well, Robert, we saw your video when you first came in to the NBA with the Golden State Warriors, played 4 years at Golden State, then in a major trade, sent to Boston, and where Robert really developed into a Hall of Fame player, obviously with the likes of Larry Bird, Kevin McHale, Dennis Johnson, the list could go on and on, but that core group of Parrish, McHale, and Bird are all in the Hall of Fame. So how did you get your game, Robert, from here to here?
Like I've said before, when I first came into the league, Chuck, I didn't feel like I was NBA ready. So I have to continue to work and improve, work on my weaknesses. Now, first of all, I wasn't strong enough. I felt like my shooting had to get better. I was basically one-dimensional. I came into the league as a jump shooter. I didn't have a hook shot, so I built up a hook shot, both hands, right and left hand. I felt like my ball handling was suspect, even though seven-footers not known for their ball handling skills, but I feel like it was important. I feel like every athlete, ball player, no matter your height, should be able to dribble the basketball, the length of the court. So those are the things that I worked on. Those were my weaknesses coming into the NBA. And also, I had the luxury of not being thrown to the wolves, so to speak. I wasn't asked to come in and play right away. And that also helped with my growth and confidence.
And confidence is so important, because none of us are perfect. We're going to have our down days. We're going to have our down games. How did you handle disappointment and knowing that there was a game around the corner, but still, you knew in your own heart, I should have played better. Maybe I missed some shots. Maybe I missed defensive assignments. We're not perfect, as I mentioned. How did you, as a ball player, break through that?
Well, it's something, as I said earlier, my junior high school coach instilled in me. Gotta always believe in yourself. You gotta have unshakable confidence in yourself, because there were high expectations for me. I was the eighth player taken in the first round. And I was the first player taken by the Golden State Warriors back in 76. So there were very high expectations of me. So as I said earlier, I had the luxury of taking 2 or 3 years to develop. I didn't have to come in and play right away. And I think that was one of the saving grace for me.
Yeah, especially for young people. And we're going to talk more about Robert's career. We also want to remind you the importance of education, going to class. If you struggle in a certain class, and we've all been there, you know, there are teachers, there are people that are ready to help you out. And just like a coach, a teacher is a coach as well. May not have all the X's and O's as far as basketball is concerned, but a teacher can help you and encourage you to be a better student with skills that will help you later in life. And Robert, this is what it's all about. I mean, here we are talking to a Hall of Fame player today, and you go about traveling throughout the world representing the National Basketball Association, and you've learned a lot in your career. What are some of the things you've learned about yourself that basketball taught you?
How to get along with others. The great thing about sports on any level, it teaches you to get along with others. So, someone that's different from yourself, got different belief religiously, politically, culturally, and sports bridges that gap between culture. I think it transcends everything, like music does. Music transcends culturally, religiously, politically, and I feel like sports does the same thing. So I think it's very important that you realize that what athletics can do for you. And also, it builds confidence in other areas, like building friendships. You get the chance to meet people that you normally wouldn't meet through sports. You get to travel places that you normally wouldn't go because of athletics, because of sports. And also, it gets you away from your parents. And it's another way of showing your parents how much you appreciate what they're doing for you. And so I think it's a thing I want to touch on too, and tell your parents how much you appreciate the sacrifices that they're doing for you. Our parents do not get enough recognition. And one way, not only verbally, but another way to show your parents your appreciation is to excel, not only in the classroom, but as a person. Carry yourself with pride and dignity. And that's another way to compliment your parents, because you are a reflection of your parents. And one more thing to remember, everybody sitting in the audience, young and old, is a role model for somebody. Somebody's watching you, your every move, every word you say. So you should be cognizant of that.
Wow, great stuff from Robert Parish, huh? All right, thank you, Robert, very well said. You know, when I was going through the lobby yesterday and...